Hey there everyone, Chrissy here for ThermoWeb, and we are going to make these super cute bags today. I am going to use the clear toner sheets. These are kind of like a fall edition of these toner sheets, so here's a quick look at a few of them. I love pretty much all things fall, so this really spoke to me. So I die cut them out using a little bag, and in order to create the bag, you have to die cut it twice. So I did that, and now I am just cutting out some foil, and I'm sticking it onto the clear toner. You can do them separate and everything if you want. I just find it easier to foil it all at once, and if you do it separate, sometimes the toner will stick to the inside of your parchment paper, so it's definitely easier to just kind of foil it all at one time. So I wanted to do multiple colors. You can just do one color if that's what you prefer, but I thought it'd be fun to kind of have like a rainbow of like Halloween-y colors. So I used black, purple, and pumpkin for this one. The other one that I did off-camera that I'll show you again at the end, I used lime as well. So now, because when I die cut it, the toner sheets are a little bit thicker than your normal cardstock, so I just had to go in with my bone folder and my scoreboard and kind of redo those score lines just to make sure they'd fold okay. So I also cut off two separate pieces, and I threw those into a laminator as well. What I'm doing is putting it in parchment paper and then running it through a laminator. And now I'm just going to die cut it with the small circle die, the small stitch circle die. And that's just going to be like a little kind of built-in tag on the front. Just a little bit of extra decoration to give it a little bit more pop, so it's not just a plain old bag. So now here comes the assembly. This is probably the hardest part of it just because it's a 3D project. And not that it's difficult, but it's the most time consuming, I should say. So I'm just using my XL runner here. So I actually, this has been sitting in my craft room for a few weeks. I shot this a few weeks ago, and I will tell you it is still perfectly together, perfectly fine. The XL runner, super strong adhesive, especially for these toner sheets, so you are good to go. You don't have to worry about it popping apart if you give it as a gift, if you put a little candy in there for the kids or down the street or whatever for Halloween, or like your child's classroom gift or whatever, it will stick on. So now I also die cut in black using that same stitch small circle die. And like I said, we're just going to kind of pop that on the front there just to give it a little something extra. If you want to customize it, instead of putting the clear toner on there, you could put names or like a little happy Halloween message, or you know, if it's just a fall bag, whatever you're doing, you can customize it any way you want. So here is what we just made. And then this is a quick shot of the other one. So thank you so much for stopping by today and taking a look at the clear toner sheets. I will see you soon. Have a great day.